My dear students, welcome to our CCS online class. How are you? Hope you are fine. I am also fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. At the very beginning of our class, I would like to introduce myself to you. I am Shahnaz Parveen, assistant teacher, English, Chattogram Collegiate School, Chattogram. Okay, dear students, before the class, I would like to show you a picture. Okay, there are also some sentences. You have to look at the sentences very carefully. Number one, I use the computer in my daily work. Number two, now I am using a computer. Here I am a user. Number three, I can do my work easily by using it. So, it is useful to me. Number four, I like it because it is not unuseful. Dear students, look at the sentences. There are some words in bold. All the bold words came from a root word. And the root word is use. Now let's see the letters which we added before or after the root word. What does it call? Okay, dear students, the letters which we added before or after the root word is called affix. And the affix which is used in front of a word to make another new word is called prefix. And the affix which we use at the end of a word to make a new word is called suffix. Dear students, today we will learn how we can make new words from a root word by using suffix and prefix. That means today our topics is suffix and prefix. Dear students, look at there is a root word use. We are going to change it by adding a suffix full. Now it becomes useful. It means able to be used. Dear students, now we are going to change it by adding another prefix an. Now the words become unuseful, which means which is useless. Okay, dear student, in that way we can make new words by using suffix and prefix. Dear students, today we are going to learn common prefixes with examples, noun suffixes with examples, the places of a noun in a sentence, adjective suffixes with examples, the places of an adjective in a sentence. Dear students, now let's see some common prefixes. In. By using it, we can make the opposite word. Active, inactive. Definite, indefinite. Valid, invalid. Attentive, inattentive. Famous, infamous. Correct, incorrect. Pure, impure. Polite, impolite. Pious, impious. Mortal, immortal. Possible, impossible. Measurable, immeasurable. An. Common, uncommon. Known, unknown. Fit, unfit. Able, unable. Wise, unwise. Social, unsocial. Kind, unkind. Dis. Like, dislike. Obey, disobey. Agree, disagree. Allow, disallow. Appear, disappear. Please, displease. Miss. Use, misuse. Conduct, misconduct. Fire, misfire. Fortune, misfortune. Guide, misguide. Lead, mislead. IR. Regular, irregular. Religious, irreligious. Rational, irrational. Responsible, irresponsible. IL. Legal, illegal. Literate, illiterate. Logical, illogical. Liberal, illiberal. Legible, illegible. N. Large, enlarge. Courage, encourage. Danger, endanger. Noble, ennoble. Evil, ennoble. Sure, ensure. B. Fool, be fool. Had, be had. Friend, be friend. Little, be little. Feet, be feet. Dear students, now let's see some noun suffixes by which we will be able to find out which words are noun. A noun generally ends with shan, shan, ion. Ends, ends, ce, cy, ity, ty, th, meant, dom, hood, ness, ior, age, ism, ist, sheep, ery, al, ing, y, etc. We can add er, ar, or, r, ee, e after a verb to make it a noun. Now, let's see what is noun. A noun is generally used in an answer of what. For example, I use a computer. What do I use? In answer of a what, we get the word computer. So, it is a noun. Dear students, now let's see some examples by using these noun suffixes. Shun, education, narration, ends, ignorance, disturbance, meant. Development, government. Here the root word is develop. By using meant, we make it development. Ear, richer, taller. Here the root word is reach. ITY, TY, ability, safety. Here the root word is avail, safe. ION, selection, translation. Ness, usefulness, kindness. Here the root word is use. Hood, childhood, boyhood. Dom, kingdom, freedom. Sheep, friendship, studentship. IER, purifier, verifier. Ear, cooler, boxer. Or, inventor, editor. TH, truth, depth. URE, failure, pleasure. Dear students, now we are going to learn the places of a noun in a sentence. The noun used as a subject of a sentence. Look at the example. Education is the backbone of a nation. Education, here education is subject as an object. Happiness consists in contentment. Look at the sentence. The contentment is used here as an object. Object of a preposition. Look at the example. It depends on sincerity. Here, the word sincerity is used as an object of a preposition on, after an article. Look at the example. She is a writer. Okay. Here, the word writer used after the article A. An article plus adjective plus noun. Look at it. She is a famous writer. In this sentence, she is a famous writer. Then after the article A, we use the adjective famous and before the noun writer. After a possessive form. A noun is also used after a possessive form. Look at the example. I think about his safety. Here, his is possessive form of he, and we use the word safety noun after the possessive. After all, some, any, many, few, much, little, no, one, two, first, second. We can also use noun after these words. Look at the example. I want to know about some inventors. Here, some is a determiner. We use the noun inventors after it. After to have verb, we can also use noun. If the to have verb used in a sentence as a main verb and there is no another verb, we can also use noun after to have verb. Look at the example. He has popularity. There plus to be verb plus noun. We can also use noun in introductory there. Look at the example. There is a school in our locality. Dear students, I hope now you will be able to learn the places of a noun in a sentence. Okay, now look at some adjective suffix. An adjective generally ends with T-I-V-E, tib, I-V-E, F-U-L, less, O-U-S, able, I-C, I-A-N, I-S-H, A-L, I-N-G, L-Y, Y, some, or the. Tib, attentive, talkative, I-V-E, passive, active, full, careful, hopeful, less, useless, senseless, O-U-S, famous, nervous, able, readable, desirable, I-V-L-E, forcible, responsible, I-C, economic, telegraphic, I-A-N, Indian, American, I-S-H, bookish, childish, A-L, national, beneficial, I-N-G, running, dancing, L-Y, manly, costly, Y, greedy, angry, some, handsome, quarrelsome, or the, praiseworthy, trustworthy. An adjective generally used in answer of how. Now we will learn the place of an adjective in a sentence. Article plus adjective plus noun. Look at the example. He is a learned man. Here the word learned is an adjective. It is used after the article and before the word man noun. Possessive form plus adjective plus noun. Dear student, look at the example. English is my favorite subject. Here the word favorite is an adjective. It's used before the word subject, which is a noun, before a noun. Look at the example. This is an amusing game. The word amusing here is an adjective. It used before the word game, which is a noun, after to be verb. If the to be verb used as a main verb, we can use adjective here. Look at the example. He is popular. Not plus verb or adjective. Look at the example. He is not attentive in the class. Here we use the word attentive as an adjective after not. A linking verb. Appear, become, feel, get, look, remain, smell, taste plus adjective. That means we can use the adjective after a linking verb. Look at the example. It was getting dark. The word dark here is an adjective. It is used after the linking verb getting, after an adverb. Look at the example. She is very beautiful. Here the word beautiful, it is an adjective. It is used after the adverb very. Comparative degree plus than. We can use an adjective here also. Look at the example. He is taller than me. Here the word taller is an adjective. We use it before the word than. As an object of a transitive verb, we can use the adjective as an object of a transitive verb also. Look at the example. I will get the car ready. Here the word ready is an adjective. We use it after the transitive verb get. Now I hope the places of an adjective is clear to you. I also hope that it will be easy for you to decide where you should use noun suffixes and where you should use adjective suffixes. Dear student, I know all of you have a very clear idea about parts of speech. There are 8 kinds of parts of speech in English grammar. In our today's class, we talked about noun and adjective. We will talk about verb and adverb in our next class. Okay, now take your homework. Dear students, what you have to do? You have to take at least 25 root words which you have to turn into noun and adjective by using suffix and prefixes. Okay, no more today. Hope you will safe and sound at your home and maintain the rules of hygiene and cleanliness. Bye.